Welcome back. We've got all this warm weather, good for the fruit here in Colorado, yeah. At the very least.
I know, it's got the cantaloupe ready, it's in the stores. Yeah. I'm excited, I love cantaloupe. My kids do too.
The peaches are pretty good too this
year. They are, they're fantastic already.
Peaches, yeah.
Yeah.
Good stuff.
Yeah, unfortunately not everyone likes the heat as much as maybe our fruit.
Yeah.
It's hot on the people. Especially those folks out there working in the field. Look at the temperatures though in Grand Junction, 77 degrees at 5:15 in the morning.
Wow.
69 here in Denver, 61 in Greeley, 64 in Fort Collins. Burlington, your temperatures, 65 degrees right now. So most of us are in these 60s. There are a few 50s, but not much at all. Our humidity slightly lower today than we were yesterday. We're only about 41% right now, and just a very light wind, anywhere from about 10 to 15 miles per hour. It's going to be a very pleasant morning for most of us. However, it's going to heat up, and it's going to heat up pretty quickly. Look at our temperature jump. Jumping into the 80s by lunchtime, then we're going to jump even higher. You're going to see our temperatures close to triple-digit heat by this afternoon, and we're going to keep those warm temperatures through our early afternoon and evening hours. Now, there is a very slight chance that some of us could see some storms, mostly in the mountains, so I'll take you through future casts. Starting this at 7 o'clock, you'll see some of those storms begin to build around 1 o'clock. It looks like they're going to start a little bit later in the day today than what we saw yesterday. Most of it's all going to stay in that higher elevation. As you can see, this is what it looks like around 6:30 this evening. Other than that, that's going to basically remain kind of through the overnight hours into the mountains, and then you can even see some of these storms about 7 o'clock tomorrow morning begin to build. It looks like tomorrow is going to be our best chance to see some of those storms, as hopefully they're going to make their way towards that I-25 corridor and give us a better chance at some rain showers. Let's widen it out, show you the statewide view. Also starting at 7 o'clock this morning, you're going to see a big section in the southwest corner of those storms begin to build. It's going to push off to the east, but we're not going to really get close towards that I-25 corridor. You're going to see it stick again, mostly in the mountains. The foothills could see a shower or two, maybe a thunderstorm or two, but most of it, again, is just going to remain in that higher elevations until tomorrow, that is. So look at our temperatures, our highs for today, 96 in Denver, 97 in Greeley. Burlington, you're going to be close to triple-digit heat there at 98. Lamar, 101. Sterling, 98. Grand Junction, you're also going to be at 98. The mountains are going to be cooler, but still pretty warm for them. Look at this. Eagle 90, Vail 83, Breckenridge 76 here in the Front Range. So we're going to be dealing with the low 90s, Castle Rock, Parker, and Littleton both at 93 to the mid to the upper 90s. You're going to see Greeley at 97, Fort Morgan at 98 degrees. Now, you want to know how much we need rain? Take a look at our current drought conditions. The dark, dark kind of orangey red, that is exceptional drought. The orange there, that's extreme drought. And then the yellow, that is just drought condition. So the entire state is covered in that drought, and we are in dire need of rain. May see some tomorrow, and then it looks like Tuesday is going to be our next best chance to see some of those rain showers push through. But other than that, Mitch, it's 90s, and they are here to stay.